to speak. Good morning, everybody. I'm Elizabeth Ree, and I'd like to thank Alison for that wonderful talk because I think it is important. I'm a councillor at the City of Stirling. I'm also the North Metropolitan candidate for the Western Australia Party, which actually started in 1906, and the first member was Lord Forrest. And then it decided that it was too hard for the East, so it decided that in 2017 it needed to be re-erected because Labor and Liberal weren't listening to Western Australia. So that's how that came about. I'm a councillor at the City of Stirling. I was the first councillor to put up in all our local governments throughout Western Australia third party appeal rights, because it's becoming, and that was before they started with the emergency regulations that Alison mentioned. With the third party appeal rights, we see it every day, whether it's two storey building next year or a 10 storey building next year, you do not have any rights. And that is one of the most terrible things in our democracy these days. So I put it through council. I was very happy that Charles Smith, the Western Australian representative in Parliament, actually put it up as a motion in Parliament. And other than Alison, the Greens, they supported the Western Australia Party. Not one Labor, not one Liberal, not one National Party person in the upper house supported the rights of people to have their say. Rights of people to appeal, rights of people to make a comment. And I think people really seriously need to think about that in the upper house when they vote. The upper house should be democratic, shouldn't be the same as the lower house, and please put that in perspective. With regard to Bush Forever sites, I have been campaigning a long time. 2010, the state government, through an MRS amendment, put in 296 Bush Forever sites throughout Western Australia, because the research people, the scientists, the community at the time said, we need to preserve these sites. We need to make sure the flora and fauna, we need to make sure that we have a buffer against the heat island effect. Subsequent governments, and as Alison made the comment about the property developers, they went to bed with the major political parties, and then they just changed the rules in Parliament. Oh yeah, that's it, we'll get rid of 100 acres down at Ocean Reef, we'll get rid of 20 acres down at Mullaloo. They've even got acres down at Margaret River. Throughout the coast, they're actually ignoring the legislation that they put in place to protect us, to protect the flora and fauna. And we really need to stand up and notice that. We really need to stand up and say, no, this isn't the way we want to go. Because it affects not only us now, but it affects the health and well-being of our children in the future. And it's all right to say all the 43 endangered species at Ocean Reef can go up to Carrabooda. I don't know if anybody looked at that plan, but last time I looked at Carrabooda wasn't on the coast. But maybe that's the next thing they're going to do is move it. It will be, that's true. We'll just, with climate change, it'll eventually move to the coast. So I think people need to put that in perspective. It's really important that you tell not one person, not two people, but 10. You need to send a strong message to government that this isn't okay, and that this is our life and the life of the future. So I'd like to really thank everybody for coming out today. Do support the politicians that are supporting you. And when you look at the council election in October, look at those councillors who voted for the business case the other day, and they are the ones that you should not vote on council, because this is about you and it's about your money. So stay safe, and we've got a week to go, so please think. Thank you.